meeting over to you, asking that you would guide us on how to handle this grant application, if we make wise decisions to determine what roads are most in need of repair, thinking that we are, we have the financial resources to be considering this. And we ask your direction today, as every day, Friday, maybe a new year.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Right, today is the 10th of January, year 2014. It's a couple minutes after 9 o'clock, and we are here today to begin our public discussion on practical aspects of forming a county energy transportation reinvestment zone. And what we want to do today is make sure that each of us understands what responsibilities we have for paperwork that will be a part of this application. And I've kind of broken it down into three areas. Does everybody have to know about, if not, I've got to give a reminder. Would you like one of our handouts to prove all of them?
$10.
No, I've got it right here. I say I'll do it. What's the cause, in your opinion, that you're roads that are needed for opening, cost of improvements, and usual cost of maintenance in the coming year. So I guess what the state is doing is taking the opportunity to get a statewide feel from the guys with eyes on the ground as to what is the status of county roads. I hope that this will not be too onerous of a task, but obviously the objective would be to list every road in your precinct, give it a rating, and give them the information that they're asking for. Does anybody think that this will be not doable in the next couple of weeks if you need more direction or instruction on this? That's what they're asking for. This is an information gathering procedure the state is asking for. This is in addition to us identifying the reinvestment zone. It's in addition to identifying the roads that we will include in the zone and the roads that we will spend this money on. So basically, they're asking you, hey, tell us about your county roads so that we can map a master database for the whole state. Because these guys don't monitor our county roads. I guess they want to get a feel for what kind of money are needed out there by county roads.
Now, what I've always learned is not everyone in there here, but they're cold, and they do it better than four. If we're breaking one line.
Yeah, you read that down at the end. One of the last ones on the right said, usual cost of maintenance in coming year for specific roads. Cost of improvements identified in the report for specific roads.
You had to explain.
Look out to well, you don't know how well you're going to fix the road. I mean, you're going
to. Obviously, this is not an exact science. It's not anywhere close. But I think you could probably get a pretty good idea. You know, if nothing more, given that scale of 1 to 5, that's going to tell a lot. If they say that it's 5, they know that there's not much money that needs to be spent there. And you can ballpark, you know, given the number of miles we're talking about, the length of the repairs that need to be made. Grant, I'm the last one that needs to be killed and have to inform me of it because I don't have a clue. But I would say that we can do our best. There's no other commissioner in this state that needs more adept at filling out a form like this.
I got a call yesterday from Commissioner of the River County. He said January the 16th that they had a man coming over there to their extension office to kind of sit down with them and tell them basically how much to charge for each individual thing. You know, he said like for your trucks and all that stuff. You know, so. And he invited us over. You know, I didn't know if everybody would go over. He said everybody's welcome to come if they want to. Or just one of us to go over there. It's next Thursday. So, but anyway, but they had somebody come over and tell them basically about how much they was expected to charge or accept for the services and stuff like that.
You mean like our materials?
Well, like our materials, like our materials would be what, I guess what we're contracting for, but like equipment and stuff, you know.
Your truck,
your equipment. And he said like, for semis, I think I got this right. He said they was talking about like 85 cents a mile, which, you know, that barely gets the diesel. So it's, I'm just, you know, I'm going to go over there and take a listen and see what they say, see if they have anything as far as paperwork and all that, to see if what they're expecting.
I think the three of you know enough about how to fix the road.
Well,
that you can provide adequate information.
Right. Yeah. But what I'm saying is the state may have different ideas as to what things may cost.
That's true. But remember, the purpose of this is not to determine the amount of your grant. It's not to determine
right.
how much money the state's going to give you. It's not to determine how much you need to budget in the coming year. It's simply
just
telling the state, right. hey, here's the shape of our roads around here.
Right. Yeah.
And I think that it's good, they ought to know that stuff, so they can use that information to project, you know, what kind of road improvement. We know what the state roads need, we know what the federal roads need. We don't know what the county needs, how much money these guys need, how much, when we're figuring out ways to raise money out here in Austin, how much should we be thinking out about to help these counties out? Well, there's an offer from Red River.
Yeah.
Where will they be?
It'll be at their extension office there in Clarksville.
What do we get for that now, road bridge, what do we get for the state now?
About 5,000.
Yeah.
About 5,000.
Then give us in kind materials so that they, when they back all that down, so we give us in kind.
I understand what Brian's talking about here, this is every road, they want to know the status of what you think would cost to fix every road in your precinct, not just the ones you're clustering.
Cost of maintenance.
Totally separate exercise, that's right.
Yeah.
That believes a lot. You don't think the state's gonna take over paying for the roads, they're trying to get push stuff.
They haven't told us what their purpose is, but for some reason, this annual road report is not something new.
Hopefully, they're here.
It's very, it's a lot of sin.
And you don't send me, it's due before.
What do you do?
You just keep it in mind.
That's not a business.
There shouldn't be variables about this road.
Yeah.
That's just gonna make it, you just want to get it as best you can.
Don't think it hung up on the exact.
The thing about that.
It's on the ballpark, they're gonna count number, and I don't know how they'll ever give y'all any more money, not at least this money came through, so maybe there are some.
Could come, reps, could.
Yeah, maybe there's some reps out there that are trying to get some more money from the rural counties.
And I need to energy company to pay this money.
It's all.
Well, I didn't mean, but still, they're paying because of the legislature, basically, made them pay it.
One after all the gas and all discoveries down in West Texas, and have land surplus of money right now, the state does. And they're wanting to go back to all the counties and try to help some of the roads and stuff, because there's more than just gas, we got a lot of trucks, big trucks, all of this type of stuff, and they want to kind of help their county out. This money comes strictly from all the gas revenue, $249 million strictly to all the counties.
If I understand it right, Brian, from me and your talk, even though we're gonna designate certain areas to be in the search, we're not gonna have to spend this money just in, we can spend the money anywhere in the precinct rules.
On roads.
Realistically, we're gonna form one small CETRZ, just to meet the requirements of this grant request. Now, the idea, which I still have a hard time understanding, the idea is that you can form more of these CETRZs in the future. And again, how does that generate additional revenue? Well, I guess the idea would be this, if you had a stretch of road here that's in bad shape, and you expended money on it to improve that road, perhaps you would encourage development that would increase your tax values, that would therefore bring in more money into the county that would be earmarked for road repair that you would then use for your next project. That's the theory behind it. How realistic is it? I don't know. But if there is an increase in value in an area that you designate as this zone, you are committing for a minimum of 10 years that any increased tax revenue because of valuation increase is earmarked only for road work. So you deny your general fund of those monies. So it's not like it's creating new money, but in certain circumstances, in certain areas, it could.
I guess the appraisal lady will have to identify that.
We'll go over some more of that. And you'll have to set up a specific account that has a unique name for it.
She'll have to identify for me when she sends us over the evaluations, this much of your evaluation is due to an increase in the valuation of that CETRZ, and so that's the amount of money I'm going to have to set aside for separate funds.
What we'll do, here's a graphic picture of a road with several parcels around. And once we identify this zone, we'll say, okay, Geraldine, all these parcels, you need to start keeping us posted
if the valuation goes up.
Because when that valuation goes up and we reap additional county revenue funds, we set it into a separate fund. Now, if we pick out an area that has virtually no hope of ever seeing any real improvement over the next year, you know, some road up in far north county that's always been the same, and there's no development going to occur, obviously it's a moot point. But it'll still qualify for what we're doing.
And we can take the $300,000 or however much they send us, and I don't have to spend that money in that zone. It can be spent wherever we want to spend it.
I am reading that the zone must include one of the roads that you're going to do some work on. I need to be a little more sure of that, but that's my understanding.
Like you're right.
And I'll read you what I see there.
Some percentage.
Yeah. And it could be, you know, a half mile of road with two parcels on it.
Right.
One guy owns it on this side, another guy owns it on the other.
But the law says I've got to spend 10% of the money on that parcel, and we're going to spend 10%.
I don't know that it says 10%. You know, if you identify a zone that's only going to take $50,000 worth of work, then, you know, you've got
7% somewhere.
You know, most of the roads that we have travel like it, all get a farm on both sides, probably not everywhere you go.
That's right. And again, they're not making you do this in an area where you anticipate rapid increase in value. That's not the objective. But
if it does,
we'll get into this more later. I want to finish the discussion on necessary documentation. Does anybody else need to know about what's going to be required to complete
the process?
We have to apply between the 7th and the 20th and the 14th of February. I'd like to have all this done and ready by the end of January. I'm asking for these reports by the 23rd. Now, if you still need a little bit more time, let's just don't put ourselves in a jam where we're scrambling. Because the first week of February, we're going to be in Austin. In College Station. Okay.
I'm not sure if this will be possible.
One of the additional things that they're asking for that has not been in previous road reports is that column 3, cause of degradation. So you identify, they'd like to know, hey, what's your major problem up there? What's causing problems for your road? Is it oil and gas? Is it timber? Is it chicken? Is it just mineral traffic? What's the cause of the degradation? The next thing that you're going to be asked for will be a list of projects in each precinct to be funded by grants. We're going to take a look at the TxDOT forms. This is going to be more towards the back of your handout.
I'm going to say probably he gets, he needs to get a little more than everybody else, because he's got more gas traffic and oil traffic and up in the Calco area than not, than we do in the other part.
Again, that's not a requirement, but that is the idea behind this, is we're trying to throw some money towards oil and gas damage, oil and gas industry damage areas. But that is not a requirement. However you choose.
The first thing I had to do was big ash trucks, all that ash, and cut across on the county road, filled with speed trucks, and logs.
We all got the same problem, I've got the same thing from my business. They also have the same thing.
Y'all might have the ash truck, which y'all gonna have.
The what?
You want to have the ash truck, you might.
I got a part of that.
Well, I guess that's the first thing we decide is, if we decide that we're gonna weight this heavier in one precinct and give it a higher than 25% allocation, then that commissioner would need to come up with more projects. But because of the fact, here are a couple of reasons why we want to come up with more projects than just what we think $311,000 will cover. For one thing, we may get lucky and have more grant money come to us because other counties have not participated in this. So, for example, if we got $400,000, we certainly don't want to have only identified $311,000 because you don't get extra money over and above what you have identified as your project. So we think we're gonna get this money, we want to identify this much so that we know if for some reason some of those projects aren't doable or aren't feasible, because I know I really can't do that work. Well, that comes off of our project list. We want to be sure we've got plenty of extra projects here that we know will eat up every dollar of that grant money. Well, we can identify as many road projects as you want, and you don't have to put them in order. You're not committed to the number one first and number two second. We just want to be sure, again, that you don't have more grant money than you can spend. So I would suggest coming up with two times $311,000 or $622,000 worth of projects. Again, if you divided that equally amongst you, $155,000 per precinct. So I guess that's the first decision is. Well,
you know,
I'm shooting high. Probably not going to get that much money. Realistically, we're probably only going to get about, you know, $78,000 worth of grant money per precinct.
Now, $300,000 is not going to build a whole lot of roads.
No.
I did 3 miles last year just right out here by Eastwood Hills.
Yeah.
I spent $77,000 on 3 miles over there.
Well, I know what you're saying, Thomas. Y'all have a hard time coming up with a wish list.
No.
But just, I mean, we need to come up with a number that needs to be 155 for precinct. You don't need to, you know, if you got the money, here's what I'd like to spend.
Asking for reimbursement money on a project that we gave you up front.
but you're starting to plan to work on this, you know, it's gonna be a reimbursement, so we're gonna have to spend the money before we apply for reimbursement.
Are you still gonna, get duties, have to do this, fill it out, and you,
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I'll ask.
Yeah.
Process, but Bill, they don't know your roads, this is one of the few things, you'll do the road report, and you'll identify the projects, but then we also need to identify where we need to pick this up.
Well, you say we need to go back, like this report, where it wants to go back, right now, go back to this one, all of us.
Well, I'll say that the information that they have asked for, don't give me a report that doesn't list the cause of degradation, that's something you haven't seen before. You need to be sure you're giving them all the information and that's the wrong report.
Best thing to do is just use the report. I have to question, you're talking about using grants, most of the grants, in fact, all grants now, that we deal with, my office has to send those reports in from the verify and sign all of them. I ask them to do that on a monthly basis, or we would be doing that.
Probably be doing it.
I bet Bass doesn't do that.
Be as far as requesting reimbursement or invoices.
Right.
I have not read anything that gives clear instructions.
My guess is they want to do that, so I'll have to get that from y'all, so that I can sign off on it. You know, you're gonna give me a little more details than you usually do when you spend money.
Yeah, once you try to run on one of your projects.
You're gonna have to identify.
It'll be bookkeeping.
Where we haven't done that.
Right.
It will be bookkeeping intensive when you're working on it.
That's basically what I've been doing where, on capital, trying to get reimbursed from Exxon.
Right.
Basically the same thing.
And y'all have to do that on all your.
But we'll have to do all of that we're doing through this.
You got to, you can make, we can take this past 30 years, we're gonna have to close one.
I'm just gonna.
This road, all that transport, that long, standing,
some of the.
I'm talking about my time, you said your time would pay the bill for y'all, you're gonna spend it. And it might be four different roads you work on, you got a different bill. You may do it somewhere, but I don't track it, I'm gonna start.
We'll have a further discussion on this point later, but you're absolutely right. We're going to have to only request reimbursement for actual dollars.
Right, I'll have to show them that, because they can all do this.
Yeah, if one truck is used that day and working on three different projects, you're gonna have to figure out how to allocate the overhead on that truck, the overhead on those people and materials that go into that.
Well, that's what we left.
Same thing we did.
We did pretty much that same thing we had to do.
That's the thing about.
But we didn't have to do.
Well, that's fine. I mean, y'all can do it, it was worrying me to that, and I'll put it out on the report. That would be easier than Christie trying to track it every invoice.
I didn't pay that for my whole work for 2 days.
But y'all will have to keep that in your office.
Let's say that discussion for a time, for a little further.
Yeah.
You have a question?
Does the second page says alternate form, does that mean alternate to the first page?
Yes.
So you could do without that one, just do the front page?
Well, the front page doesn't provide detail. There's no place to put the kind of detailed information on there. I think that's an old form that may have been used in the past. It looks way too summarized to me. I can't imagine that you could.
So a person probably could read out some of those columns.
No, we don't want to leave out information.
So this is stubborn.
I want to be sure everything they've asked for here, I think, is reasonable, and it is specified that they do want that information. All they're doing here is saying, hey, we put together a suggested form for you. You got it?
Yes, okay.
Everything, every column there is information that's asked for. Okay, well, talking about how we're going to allocate this money. What are we going to do? Do we want 25% each? Do we want to allocate some additional percentage? That's y'all's call. We were talking about $2 million.
I have a lot of roads. My father
they fixing to hit them again, start right here for December.
Start drilling most.
We're supposed to start drilling.
So about 40% 2020, or 65%?
75%, 10, 10, 10.
70, 10, 10.
I certainly don't need as much to do with their ass, you know, that's just my, I mean.
All you're going to get is $10,000, your report would be really fair.
10%.
I mean, I'm sorry, 10%, $30,000, or double that, $60,000, you might just have one eye on your list. But it needs to be an item that you're for sure going to work on if you get this going.
One of the roads is three new roads, and I've got about 400 yards, it's county road. They tore it up, but he's got about 5 miles of that same traffic on that road. And they tear it, they, I go down the road often. It requires a lot of work, and he's got less than 5 miles.
Four.
From the bridge.
From the bridge from White Oak to 71.
40, 2020?
Either one, me.
I mean, y'all got projects too.
Or 55, 50, 50, 50, I mean, I know this particular item, I'm sure they'll bless that one, but all the citizens of the county need to help be a good sex to get them. Probably more population in some other areas than there is in that far north part.
Well, the state is not asking.
No.
On that percentage, but it'll help you to know what is my part. If I do 10% of 311 times two, or I do 20%, then you don't would have more projects on your list, or at least more expensive projects.
Well, if we get all 311, we're charging five for it. We're going to have to go 10%. 10% of it, that's $31,000, you take off that, $5,000 to that, that's $36,000 from 311. So we're not even talking about 311, we're talking about 265 or something.
Yeah, and it's still, it's not even, what other counties not involved in this, what we make here.
Yeah, that's all.
That's a good 55, 15, 15, 15, 40, 20, 20, 20.
I'm up ahead, whatever we decide, I don't have a particular one. I'm going to do mine, whatever.
Still like that.
Like you 25 or all the way around.
I don't think I have to go a little bit more, but I've really got some rubbish out there.
Oh, yeah, I know, but we can move on with that, so.
40, 20, 20, 20?
I said 40.
Well, if you don't, we don't want that much, we get.
It's not said they are, I'm just, we're going to maintain it open anyhow, just like him.
Well, you're going to maintain it with the extent I give you money in the budget, or you give yourself money in the budget. Mike may totally out of money in his budget this year.
Well, again, if you come up with four projects, then you're going to end up with money. And we can finalize this percentage later on. How about for the time being, we'll think about 40, 20, 20, 20. And that means 40% of 311 times two. You want to come up with a fair minimum of that. You got to come up with 20% times 311 times two, just a fair minimum. If you go over, that's fine. But just be sure that any project you put on this list is a project that will receive some of that money. We're all clear on that? We'll move on. Now we need to designate this area that we want to say is our CETRZ. And again, is there, let's make this simple. Let's flip over here and look at some of these changes in sizes and these suggested zones.
I'll look here anyway.
There's three pictures of suggested ways to do this zone. what's a project, let's just throw an idea out. What's an easily definable area that you got in mind up there where you know the potential?
You've got to make sure that the building, you'll work that road.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure that. What I've got, and this, when we first started talking about this, is one that I just out of the blue thought of. You know, they make them swear about coming right here, say start right here.
But the interstate is 1905 and 71.
71. Make this right through here. Kind of make that block right through there. But this,
that's a huge.
That, see, that's the thing about it. That's a huge area.
That's right here.
Right here, mainly this road right through here is where some of the old gas is. It doesn't need to be that big.
What about where the Green Hill Road ends and you go back to the left out to 71? It looks to me like that used to be a bad.
This is a heavy travel road.
1905 here.
Yeah.
It's bad.
And what I don't want you to do is give me something where I've got 200 landowners up and down
right,
the road that's
right.
Going to make the job of bookkeeping a nightmare or something with
that's 6 miles. You said four.
About 4 miles from there up to there.
I got 400 yards in that.
Yeah.
That's a heavy oil truck, tanker, cement truck, everything.
We may just pick out one that's a root section of that truck. I know they have told us how big it has.
Right. I know 6T has majority of the side here up so far, but there's several.
That would be nice and easy.
Yeah.
You could say, now, are they going to say, hey, you're picking on me? No, I'm not picking on you. What's the likelihood of us seeing a significant increase in the... Nothing we're doing here is going to cause 60 property values to go up.
Right.
We're just identifying that as an area.
Yeah.
Now, if they came in there and said, hey, y'all have fixed our road up nice, we think we're going to put a convenience store here or a gas station or something.
Well, just for hell's sake.
Then we'll be putting one back in there.
Probably not.
But that was my first.
How many houses are down there?
From 71.
What about you talking about that?
1905 from 71 down to quite over.
It's not anything. Not two or three.
From White Oak.
I think it probably is going. How much frontage would you say 16 had on?
But there's one spot there where there's one house, you know, kind of broke out in there. This goes to someone else.
Would you say that mile and a half is absolutely going to be one of your projects? If not, let's move on to another.
I mean, yeah, because if you're one of my projects, yeah. But I could take, go in there and take seal coat over that.
Or that would make our bookkeeping be simple if I had only one or two owners, but I don't want that to control where you decide to spend your money.
See, that be one little project there where that is, I can seal coat that, you know, that'd be a project.
Okay, if you want to do that, would be a reason not to do that.
There's no reason not to do that. But 16 has one side, and you have Sugar Hill Ranch on the other side, and then 3P Ranch on the other side. There's three places.
What I kind of need to do, though, is to be able to include a complete parcel in that zone, rather than saying, you know, making that zone where it splits two different parcels. That you can't really allocate the tax increase when you've got a whole parcel and you've only grabbed part of it in your zone.
Right.
So this zone needs to be made up of complete parcels, however many there are.
Okay.
I'll read this over here somewhere, right? You're going to have tax numbers on each one of the parcels.
Yeah.
We can do that. What I probably have to do is just go talk to them. Is that what?
Not really. As long as I know the area.
Yeah. Well,
if I can sit down with Geraldine on a plat map, I mean, I can literally do it from my computer now with the CETRZ software. We can identify what parcels would be included in that road. You and I can do that.
But each one on the east side is one parcel except Sugar Hill Ranch, right? That's only part of it.
They're actually, when you come up here to on the east side from White Oak Creek to 1905, this would be one parcel here. It's one landowner here.
That's one parcel.
And then you have 6T up here, and then it goes around a little house with 6T continues to go up. Right here, you have a block out of 3P Ranch, and then you have another little parcel right there. But from here to point where this little cutout is, it's about a mile and a tenth. And it's got 16 there. You have 16 here, you have Sugar Hill Ranch there, and then 3Q right there. So just make three parcels right there. That
do you think they're individual parcels rather than 16 bought 10 parcels here to accumulate their range?
Yeah, no, it is. Because 16 bought Biggie Lee's ranch, that was all one ranch. So, yeah.
And again, we could just find one side.
Yeah.
But it says they can do one side.
But there's.
But I don't have to answer more than
that. I think they better do the whole pond, but it's all one side.
Well, I say three. Down here, there's Vasquez's. There's one there. Two, three, or there'd be four.
Yeah. Before, right,
within that mile.
Or I can go sit down with Geraldine. Let me just play with this. So basically, you're telling me White Oak Creek to 1910, that area in there.
Yeah.
And that's about a mile.
That would run from there to there, be 3 or 4 miles.
3 or 4 miles.
Yeah.
Ballpark idea of what that project would cost to do what you want to do.
What were you going to do?
Seal coat.
I'm fireflies, I think.
You can call that out.
Yeah.
Well, again, we're talking $10,000 or $200,000.
No, we can say, what, $35,000?
More than.
Maybe more than.
Oh, $15 $100,000.
Well, yeah.
Grounds are going up, you wouldn't have to go where it's other to.
They model, you know, get a couple more parcels to make certain, because that road needs.
Well, again, we don't have to spend all the money on that project, I just want to be sure that that project will be one that.
That was due, yeah.
It's got to be something, it's done, that project.
Right, that, yeah.
So, but now, Pat, and we're always good, I had him come back here and ask him what he called that.
Joey's the one that paid that. Joey, Howard, because he does all that, but he's the one.
Exactly.
I got Pat sales from the office.
But he would do the work here.
He could.
Well, he could.
He would have to.
He could do the work, I mean, we've got the equipment, but, I mean, it was, it's.
I bet you have a stripper wouldn't.
It probably would.
A stripper, the truck, it was fishing in the wind.
But they.
They need more efficient to hire somebody to try to do that.
Probably. Because last time we used that, we had a lot of trouble with it.
Do you want to make that zone a little bigger than that, 3/4 of a mile? I'm not encouraging you, I'm just.
Well, I mean, it would be.
We talked about, are we going to work all the way down here, or is it mainly going to be here?
I've done a mile, this past year, I've done the first mile here. And I can't remember, it may be.
If you just see a couple of little trucks going, you just took them in.
Yeah, well.
You're going to just put some kind of lace under that.
I've gone from here, say, to, I can do 2 miles of, you know.
How many parcels you think I'll end up with?
Well, there again, it's going to be more than.
Why don't you just let me do some research, and if y'all will just let me get back to Philip, and I will come up with what we think of.
That, I'll give you that number.
And I'll go back to you, and I'll show you, here's how many parcels, here's the length.
I mean, is, we could designate this, say, 1 mile, right here. And like I said, there's not the three.
But again, I want to be able to have a complete parcel in there. If 6T goes, if their one parcel goes all the way up here, I can't split that one parcel.
Okay.
I've got to have 8.
You got it.
I thought you were going to do the whole thing.
So let me, let's, we can, I'll go back and see how many parcels would make a reasonable business there, and I'll show you.
All the way to the end of 6T's, then come.
Good bait.
Yeah.
All right, well, that'll be my focal point. Let me get on the TCAD map and see if I can find that. Okay, so we'll describe, kind of describe that for me just verbally. Approximate 2 mile stretch from
White Oak Creek north, say 2 miles.
2 mile stretch of 1905 from White Oak Creek north to approximately, is there something up here that would be extended point at the end of the 6T property?
End of 6T property. Road property.
Frontage property.
Frontage property. Frontage. Yeah, there's a word.
But now, if that, let me ask you this, if that parcel ends up being all that, it doesn't really matter. Is there any reason to believe we won't see a significant increase in value on the 6T range?
That only value you see on there is if they do any more hay medicine, you know. That'd be bad. I don't figure they would build any more houses.
Because if they do, we're committing the increase to the growth fund, which again is not necessarily bad.
Right. I don't look forward to within the next 10 years.
Okay. All right. copies or, you know, if you're writing this, you don't have to fill in these little tiny blanks to get this information. But they're asking you to designate a name for your project. County Road 1905, that's all you need to name. Project limits? You say Wild Creek North to end of 60 property.
Frontage property.
Scope of work?
Field code.
Type of facility? Two-lane rural?
Existing surface. The asphalt.
Competitive bid or county fortress, that's where you have to call. When do you anticipate construction begin? When do you think it'll end? How much money for engineering, right-of-way, construction, total project cost? And we have to do the 90-10 allocation because we're only going to get 90% that we have to put up in this session.
Just going to say, you're going to have to do more than seal it. You have to prepare it before you seal it.
Yeah, you're going to have gravel in that, I think.
Yeah, it hadn't been long since I rebuilt that end, but.
We don't have to decide on the cost right now. Just know that may be where you end up with it. That may be where you spend every bit of this. Maybe half of it, maybe a quarter of it. Doesn't really matter. I'm just saying, if that's the information you're asking for, we need to find the cost. So Al, for you, you're looking to do about $120,000 for the project. $300,000, $20,000, $60,000. $250,000. If you go a little bit above, that's okay. But again, just be sure the project you list is the project you'll be able to use in those funds on. That's really all I have on that discussion, possible project to be funded. I've given you on this page, on the agenda page, if there's any question that you want to talk directly to an expert on, or at least the best expert we got, there's Eric McGee that I've been working with at Allison Bass. There's his phone number and email. If you want to talk to Pat, there's Rick Thompson. I don't think there's any real technical issues you're going to have to deal with. Your objectives now in the next couple of weeks are to do your road condition report and to come up with your projects and define those projects. I'll get back to you once I come up with that zone defined by a partial and make sure you're happy with that to make sure Gerald needs to vouch for. Any other questions or comments? You might think 2 weeks from now is 2 weeks from Monday is
2 weeks. I'll
be busy. All right, I appreciate you giving your time.
You
know,
I'd get up.
You need Carol's help and he was something up.
I won't have to sharp my pencil several times to fill in the little.
I'll just look at them again.
Again, don't worry about using that form. Just give them the information that they're asking.
I might put some down on the box.
You may do a whole page. Here's my project one. Just list them out. Here's the cost. Here's the time frame. Here's the description of the road. There's nothing magic about this form. This form just shows the right information. Narrative or just listed in one line at a time. All right. I'm going to move for adjourn. Say for adjourn.
Somebody.
We'll see you all Monday. Relatively short, at least as far as number of items on the Monday agenda, but we'll have a
Well, we just turn the name in, they pick it, and it's not all the names. We turn the name in.
Well, it's a little bit different in that we've had a board member resign. This is not like, oh, one of the guys we put on there didn't take it. And we can do a little bit of a process, so you can think about this.
Well, I guess it was a letter, and she said that the board was selected.
Yeah, you just turned it, Tim told me.
Here's what they say. Please find the official results of the, well, there, yeah, here are the official results of the email. According to section 6.03 of the property tax code, if a vacancy occurs on the board of directors, other than a vacancy in the position held by the assessor collector, serving as non-voting director, in other words, we lose a board member for whatever reason, each taxing entity is entitled to vote by this, that's entitled to vote, may nominate by resolution adopted by a government body a candidate to fill the vacancy. The unit shall submit the name of its nominee to the chief appraiser within 45 days after the vacancy, and the chief appraiser shall prepare and deliver to the board of directors within the next 5 days the list of nominees. The board of directors shall elect by majority vote of its members. So there, that's who will make the decision. They're asking for your input on this. And if you want to tell them, we're happy with giving the position to the next highest vote getter, they can do that. They just want some guidance. I think the next highest vote getter was the fellow from Rivercrest, David Ryder.
Well, the father's son.
It's Kurt Lee of Gary Bank. It's his father-in-law. I've spoken with David Ryder on the phone. He is interested, so he's not really doubt he's going to say, oh, I.
David Ryder is Kurt Lee's father-in-law.
Amy Ryder is who he married. Okay, well, that's the only other. Adjourn. Who made that motion to adjourn?
The motion.
Second by Commissioner Hockaday, second by Commissioner Bill Dalton.